Langfuse offers LLM application and agent observability that is framework, model, and cloud agnostic and open source. This, it can be self-hosted or you can use our managed Langfuse cloud service. We focus on interoperability and that it's really production grade and everything is based on OpenTelemetry. Why do you need LLM application tracing or observability? Mostly because these applications get increasingly complex and agentic with reasoning, tool calls, context management, and so many models to choose from, that traces are a great way to represent what's going on in these applications, both in production and in test environments. Traces serve as the basis for interactive debugging in development, understanding agent user behavior in production, production evaluation, as you can run evals, add user feedback, and manually label traces, and the basis for creating evaluation and benchmarking data sets, or the data layer for sophisticated monitoring and reporting of availability, latency, and costs of your applications. After this quick overview, let's jump in a quick demo so I can show you all of the core features of Langfuse tracing. When you check out this interactive demo, you can also create your own account without a credit card to browse the Langfuse UI. And you basically need to here interact with a chatbot that answers questions about Langfuse, which is then traced in Langfuse. You can look at how this looks like in the Langfuse UI in a bit. After we've asked a question, basically this Q&A agent will fetch a couple of Langfuse docs pages, reason about them, and then summarize the answer for the end user. Great. So I have an answer. Okay, perfect. This should then also be enough as basically like some demo content that we can look like in Langfuse itself. So let's log some user feedback. Worked. And switch to the Langfuse UI. Here in the tracing section, the two traces show up with the two messages that we just created. Each of them is backed by this whole trace, where it shows us the timeline of basically ending the chatbot message and then using an OpenAI model for the initial selection of tools, then separate tool calls with our MCP server, and then a final summary response. This is like the kind of agent that we're building here. These traces all include references to the chat session, so we can see how to set up my Python application, and below give me a code example so we can like understand what went on in this conversation step by step. And they are linked, for example, also to user ID. So you can dig deeper into the chat sessions that I, as a user, did on the Langfuse example application. As we added user feedback, we can also filter by it. To easily get to all of the applications where users complained, go through them to understand, for example, specific patterns. Or we can check for all of the ones that included errors. So here we have a couple of traces where every time like some tool calls errored because we had some MCP server issue yesterday. Awesome. We'll explore more of this interface in a bit. Before that, let's have a look into the data model of Langfuse. We use OpenTelemetry traces and they contain a list of different spans or generations, which are basically LLM-specific spans that include prompts, token usage, cost details, streaming response times. And these can be infinitely nested to basically model how your application actually looks like. You can customize this as you would like across the different integrations. When you integrate with Langfuse, you can follow the Get Started guide for popular SDKs and frameworks. But we really maintain lots of different integration points. One, there are our SDKs. So for example, for Python, when we go for instrumentation, there's this observe decorator that can instrument any Python function. You can use context managers if you want to customize this more, or you can go fully manual and just start spans by our SDK. The same applies to JavaScript TypeScript. Besides that, you can use our OpenTelemetry endpoint directly. So if you, for example, operate on Go, .NET, or Java, you can use the OpenTelemetry SDKs for these languages to then log OpenTelemetry traces to this endpoint. and we follow the open telemetry Gen AI semantic conventions. So basically, if you log data to us, it looks great, and you can also ingest the same traces into other platforms, and it will look very similar, which is a huge side of like interoperability of OpenTelemetry as a transport. Besides these core integrations, the community and we as core maintainers maintain lots of framework, model provider, and gateway integrations. So for example, with AutoGen, CrewAI, ESPy, LangChain, LangGraph, for Identic AI. And for all of these integrations, if we just go in, we can basically see like an end-to-end example where, for example, for Identic AI, we just need to initialize the Langfuse client and then add the Identic AI instrumentation. If we afterwards call the agent, we'll see traces in Langfuse without any kind of additional integration or instrumentation code. And this is fully interoperable with our Python SDK. So if we, for example, have this my instrumented function where we add the observed decorator and then make an LLM call via Identic AI, this will be automatically nested. So there's no overhead on your side to add any instrumentation. And this works across our SDKs and across all different integration points. Next to this, we also offer lots of model provider specific documentation, gateway specific implementations, instrumentations, and no-code integrations with, for example, OpenWebUI, LangFlow, LangDoc, FlowWise. So yeah, integrations are really where Langfuse shines because it's like open and interoperable. This is really core to the platform. When you use Langfuse for tracing, we derive lots of different metrics from these traces. When we go to the home dashboard, we can check out our overall volume that we had with this example app, how model costs are broken down between different models, how our different eval scores work, more on this in the eval video, trace volume over time, cost breakdowns by models. I mean, this application is very cheap by different models or by the type of tokens, which users were the most expensive, how our latencies work across the different span types and tool calls, latencies if we want to detect whether like a specific model regresses in speed over time. And for all of these like evaluation scores, we can see histograms and moving averages. These are like, this is like the standard dashboard. In addition to this, you can also build custom dashboards. For example, we've built like a cost dashboard, but you can go fully custom by creating your own widgets off of the data in Langfuse if you want to like explore what works, what doesn't, what's slow, what's expensive. Langfuse is open, so you can export all of the data. For example, via the UI, we here have all of the traces with an error level count. You could export all of them via CSV. Then we can use our public API to basically get all of these traces either as lists or single traces. We maintain typed SDK methods to also fetch them. We see the specific documentation on this. And if you want to export data in bulk, you can head over to integrations, blob storage, and for example, export to S3, Azure, or any other S3 compatible storage, where then Langfuse in batches exports the data to this blob storage to, for example, analyze it in BigQuery or Snowflake. In addition to the features that I've already demoed, there are like a couple of additional ones that I want to show you, where there are like sessions we already discussed, users we already discussed. There are a couple of LLM-specific features, as, for example, agent graphs. So for agent frameworks, we ran out this graph view, and we're currently working on extending this to all Langfuse traces. We allow for multimodal traces, so you can render images inline, audio, and play it directly, or any file attachments. Langfuse cost tracking allows for like standard cost tracking for all the default model vendors, but you can also fully customize this to report token counts and then maintain mappings of token counts to US dollar costs within Langfuse to then afterwards analyze what kind of use case or which kind of user is expensive, or then, for example, also get this via an API. So you can get, for example, time series metrics via API that then you can use for your own reporting. Besides that, we also have all of the like common generic observability features, as, for example, being able to log to different environments, mask PII or sensitive data, so you can apply your own masking functions. You can sample data, which is usually not recommended in file applications because you don't know which trace is really, really valuable in the end. If you work on like a high throughput environment, this would make sense. And log labels were just shown during the demo, so you can log warnings or traces. There's a lot more to explore here. This was like the highlight reel. You can, for example, add like custom metadata to attach whatever you actually want, or like there's some guidance on distributed tracing. So overall, Langfuse tracing is an extremely mature product. It doesn't add any latency to your application because all of this is fully async. Langfuse is not in the critical path. And Langfuse is open, based on open telemetry. You can export all of the data. You can customize what you see. And yeah, extend it in the ways that you want because you can write data from whatever application stack. And then you can also get the data out if you want to do some custom UI renderings or whatever you want to build around and on top. Langfuse tracing is integrated with prompt management and evals. We'll allude to these integrations in the specific videos over there. And if you want to get started, I can recommend the Get Started guide. If you have any questions, I recommend the troubleshooting FAQ section or basically reaching out to maintainers or using this Ask AI bot to get common questions answered while working on the initial instrumentation.